At the developmental time period of adolescence, children start learning more about what they like, dislike, and how they fit in with their peers. This time in their lives is heavily influenced by experimentation. This experimentation may include the use of drugs and other illicit substances. Their experimental phase with particular substances may put them in harm's way and impact their developing brain. This video aims to explain addiction in adolescence as presented by the National Institutes of Health Seminar on Brain Development in Adolescent and Addiction Risks and the Use of Digital Phenotyping to Predict Addictive Behaviors. So let's learn more about the factors that contribute to addictive behaviors. There are two main factors that contribute to addictive behaviors. These include biological and environmental factors. Both factors influence how addictive behaviors are formed in children at an early age. Everyone has a unique biology. Their genes and physiological sensitivity to illicit substances plays an important role in their risk of becoming addicted and abusing substances. Your genetics contribute to a 40 to 60% risk of drug addiction, and depending on which developmental stage you are at, the brain will react differently to exposures to different substances. Drugs have the ability to exert long-lasting impacts on the developing adolescent brain and can increase an individual's vulnerability to addiction. Secondly, the environmental factors such as low household income, poor quality of education, parental neglect, and abuse can all lead to increased stress in the life of an adolescent. This increased stress is known to contribute to addictive behaviors and substance use disorders in adolescents. Now let's focus on the effects of addiction on adolescent brain development. The brain is constantly developing from the fetal stage in the mother's womb into your mid-20s. The brain doesn't stop developing after your mid-20s, but the speed and rate of brain development is the greatest in the first 2 decades of life, and that speed decreases later in life. During the developing years of adolescence, the brain develops and strengthens neural connections through interactions in the environment. Neurons send electrical and chemical signals with important information from one area of your brain to another. With increased interactions of the environment, there are greater chances of discovering and learning from mistakes that help form neural connections in your brain. These neural connections in the brain occur at different parts of the brain at different times of the developing stage. The areas of the somatosensory cortex are fully developed in a 26 to 34 week old fetus. Somatosensory cortex is responsible for processing sensory information such as touch, temperature, and pain. This part develops early because the baby needs to receive and process sensory information from their caregivers. On the other hand, the prefrontal cortex only fully develops at 25 years old, which is much later than adolescence. The prefrontal cortex is responsible for planning, personality development, cognitive development, and executive processes. Due to later development of the prefrontal cortex, adolescents will show increased risk-taking behaviors and addictive behaviors. Brain development is also largely impacted by the environment that a child grows up in. A recent study investigated adverse childhood experiences and illicit substance use. The study revealed emotional, physical, and sexual abuse, emotional and physical neglect, household dysfunction and household substance misuse, and untreated mental illnesses to increase an adolescent's dependence on illicit substance use. Additionally, social and emotional deprivation also increases the risk of addiction among adolescents. As a matter of fact, social and emotional deprivation is one of the major reasons for brain development hindrance and deprives neural connections. A new and emerging way to study addictive behaviors is via digital phenotyping. In the world where smart devices are all around us, adolescents also have access to these devices. Using smartphones is proving to be an effective way to extrapolate data about addictive behaviors. Through digital phenotyping, you can collect information on keystroke data, in which words that are being used in text messages and social media posts are collected in real time and 24/7. A recent study conducted showed that digital phenotyping has the potential to predict relapse of substance use after clinical interventions. Machine learning showed 77% relapse prediction accuracy via digital phenotyping. Therefore, data from digital phenotyping can allow clinicians and healthcare practitioners a way to understand regional and community contexts around addictive behaviors. They can also use digital phenotyping to identify high-risk individuals that have been flagged for relapse and send them motivational messages and recommendations to sign up for follow-up appointments. In conclusion, addictive behaviors in adolescents occur due to a combination of biological and environmental factors, and the use of digital phenotyping can help us better understand their behavior and improve adolescent quality of life. We thank you for watching our video, and please don't forget to subscribe to our Demystifying channel for more information. The link for the full National Health Institute seminar has been provided in the description below. Don't forget to check it out.